This town will never change. People come and go, it's all the same. Speed the roads on a dozen days to any place that's far away. I never learned anybody's name. We all vowed that we wouldn't stay. Kissing signs on the interstate. All we do for now is sitting where.
Hey guys, so it's just gone 12 noon and I just handed in my final essay for semester one. It was on Julian's satire, The Caesars, so I'm very happy, as you can tell, that I've handed it in and I've finished semester one finally. Yeah, it's gone 12 noon, so I'm just going to go work out and just get ready for the day a little bit now, because I've been working on this since like the morning. So yeah, and I'm going to come back up here in the afternoon, I think, and I'm going to try and prep for one of my semester two modules, because semester two starts, yeah, in about 3 days. So this one is on ancient prehistory, and it's going to be on like the Mycenaeans, the Minoans, but it is an archaeology module. And I've not done archaeology yet. I've been recommended some pre-reading by the lecturer. He said, you know, if you've not read like on archaeology theory before, then you need to read this. So yeah, it's all gonna be a bit new to me, but I'm excited. So yeah, that's my plan for the day and I will take you guys along with me. So I just got ready for the day now and I just got some book mail, which is awesome. So I just got Sentinel by Jennifer L. Armentrout, because this is the series that I'm currently reading. So this is the fifth and final book in the series, which is crazy. So yeah, I'm just going to go make some lunch and then me and my friend are just going to chill and watch Netflix, really. Because we've all finished exam season now and it was quite a tough exam season, so yeah, I'm excited to finish Apollyon and then start reading this. And I ride up town. Yeah, we invent our own little games. Hey guys, so it is Sunday morning and I'm just having some breakfast. So I've got some porridge and some banana. I used my coconut milk cup as well because I think coconut milk tastes so good. And then I'm also watching the Winx saga at the moment. Me and my friends are watching this and I fell asleep last night on the sofa as we were finishing it, so I'm catching up on what I missed it there. And then I'm also going to start planning out my my day today. And I've also got my trusty coffee over here because I did not know what I would do if I did not have a coffee every single morning. And yeah, it's sunny outside and the weather's nice, so it's gonna be a good day. So I have just, well, I've not cleaned my room, but I've sorted out this lovely corner. So I thought I'd just quickly show you it. So basically I've just started doing some lectures, so I've just got those out. This is like an introduction to Aegean prehistory. So this is kind of like my little desk setup. Might as well show you guys now. I like to have it overlooking the street because then I've got like all the natural sunlight. Okay, so I'm gonna have to just explain this one now. Okay, so I've been egged twice and I don't really understand it because I don't speak to anyone. I stay in my room, I go to work. I don't know many people. So this is the second time as well, within like a week. So it happened the first time and I cleaned it straight off because I was like, oh, this is disgusting. I had just come back in from work from like an evening shift. And then a week later, it gets egged again. And I've got my theories. Because now I've been thinking about this, it's very strange. I think that because I leave my lamp on my desk at night, someone was just thinking, you know, oh, someone might be in there, let's like play a prank, it's funny. Well, the thing is, I'm very lazy as a person. So that means that this has been on my window for about 2 months now. And I'm just a bit like scared to clean it. It looks really disgusting, so I want to clean it, but it looks horrible. Anyway, so I've spent the rest of the day putting some shelves up. So I've got some really cute shelves. And they're just like macrame on the top. And I think the macrame style looks really lovely because it suits the hanger that I've got here. Also, look at this plant. I've named this plant Ariadne, and Ariadne is literally dying for the sunlight. I mean, can you honestly see? She is trying so hard to get sunlight, bless her, but I have literally placed her in the most awful spot. So, I'm very sorry. I'm very, very sorry. I do need to sort all these books out, so we ignore that. We ignore it, as well as this corner. We ignore it. I mean, it looks like they're all doing well. Not precarious at all. So yeah, I think it's about 3 o'clock now. Half three, four. I'm going to do some seminar prep for one of my modules, my Asian prehistory module. So we're looking at Knossos, and yeah, we're just analysing kind of like the Greek history before Sclemon. He was an archaeologist who excavated at Hisarlik, which is the site of Troy. Then we're going to look at Arthur Evans and his excavations at Knossos. And yeah, I honestly could not even explain to you guys how excited I am for this module. The two other ones that I'm doing for this semester aren't live yet, but those are, like, one of them is Portfolio in Ancient History. I think that looks at all the authors of like ancient history, and we have to pick out certain authors and kind of write about their works. I'm not 100% sure yet. And then the next one that I'm doing is on the Caesars, so it's on like the first kind of emperors of Rome, and that looks really, really interesting as well. So I've got an awesome semester coming up. I'm so happy with my semester. So yeah, that is what I'm going to do for the rest of the day, and then I'm just going to call some of my friends and my family. Yeah, and I'll catch up with you guys in a bit.
Yeah, I know that I've got this all wrong. I'm reaching out to touch you now, but baby, I'm clutching at straws.
My lecturer is literally hilarious. I need to show you guys this. So basically he's talking about Sclemon and his excavation at Mycenae. So I'm just gonna play it for you.
Excavations were banned even by the standards of the time. He took absolutely no notice of them and excavated anyway. Just as today, the laws that apply to the rest of us didn't apply to the rich.
My lecturer is a socialist. You know, when your poster is just about to fall down, and can you hear that? There we go. This is literally the most annoying poster. So it's my Matisse poster, and it's so gorgeous, but it just won't fucking stay on the wall, and it's really infuriating me at this point.
I haven't been drinking that much, but it's not at its finest at the minute. I really like this.
Okay, so I had a banana bread in the oven while I was showering, because I finally made my banana bread, and it's rose a little bit more than what I expected. But can I say, guys, I'm an awful cook, baker, I'm awful at everything. But I mean, I know that this is a bit... But look how much this baby has risen. I mean, it's literally like exploded. It's like a volcano. I don't know what's happened. I didn't put any baking powder in it. I mean, what? Is it good? It is.
Oh, that was so good.
Hey, so another thing that I really like to do on Sundays is kind of plan my week out. So because I kind of have my part-time job as well, I think I just find it really, I don't know, if I find it easier just to plan out, like, when I'm working, when I've got live lectures and seminars, just that I know that I can get everything done on time. So in here, this is where I kind of plan all my weeks. So I've started up my week one of my semester two. I haven't actually finished this yet. I've just started writing this down. So basically, yeah, I'll just kind of tick off the lectures that I've watched, I've made notes on, and then the seminar work and stuff like that. And I'll do that for all three of my modules in here. So that this is kind of like my academic planner. And then in this one, I kind of write down all of, yeah, when I've got work. So here I've kind of, yeah, written when I've got work. And then on my days off, like on my day off on Wednesday, I'm gonna go into town, go to the doctors and stuff like that. So yeah, I just find it really nice having that organization.
Places like Egypt. However, there's a problem. And the problem arises from the other form of arriving at absolute dates in archaeology, which is scientific dating.
Again, please.
Do you want your Jennifer Larman travel?
Hi guys, so it's about 2 a.m. and I'm just kind of finishing my chapter of Apollyon by Jennifer L. Armentrout, and then I'm going to go to bed because I've got to be up for work tomorrow morning, so I need to be up at kind of like 8:30-ish. So yeah, I probably, yeah, I won't vlog tomorrow or Tuesday, but we'll see. So if not, then I will see you guys next on Wednesday. Now Wednesday morning. Yeah, I look like a toad today. This is my horrible bed hair and I need to like brush it. It looks horrific. So I'm sorry, I apologize. It's about 10:30, and I woke up like an hour ago. Yeah, and so I'm just gonna take a bit of a chill morning. I've got quite a lot to do today because it's my day off work, so I've got quite a few errands to run. No, you don't live and expect. There must be something I don't see. Must be something I'm missing. Ain't no medicine for the weak. We are gonna. Okay, someone is actually going to need to stop me from watching all of these travel vlogs on YouTube because it is literally just making me want to travel so much. Last year was supposed to be like my year of travel, as I call it. So I was going to go to, where are we going to go? We're going to go to Prague, Rome, I was going to go to Spain for a bit. And then a couple of other little holidays that we hadn't properly planned, but we knew that we were going to try and do. Because me and my friends, we want to do interrailing, want to go to Athens and stuff like that. So obviously that didn't happen. They were all cancelled. But for some reason, I'm finding it entertaining at the moment to watch travel vlogs. So I'm watching Nana Florence and she's in Budapest right now. And I constantly rewatch Moima Winnie's video where she's in Croatia as well, because the vibes are just immaculate. So, I mean, you never know. This year might be our year of travel, 2021. You never know. We might be able to go travelling. But I say I want to go travelling, but I want to do it in the safest way possible. Obviously, we're in lockdown. I'm going to 100% respect those rules. So yeah, I just want to make that clear to everyone. I'm not gonna go to Dubai or anything like that. So yeah, I'm just gonna quickly nip to Tesco and get the essentials, which is some Cocoa Pops, because you need to have like a craving for food. My craving right now is Cocoa Pops. So that's gonna be my new breakfast food. Very healthy, as I said. But yeah, I have a live at 12, so I just need to like really quickly run to Tesco, run back, and then I'm here for my lives. Yeah, this rain is not the one. Why? I mean, to be fair, I chose the north of England for uni. It's my own fault. What did I expect? Did I expect sunny weather? I mean, I hoped for it. I've actually also got something to admit, and it is that I really need to finish this book today, Apollyon by Jennifer L. Armentrout, because what I may have done, and what I'm sure all my other little, my booktubers, my bookstagrammers, I'm sure you guys have done this as well, and I kind of lied on my reading challenge. So, January was like a really busy month for me, because I was promoted to manager that month, and I've been doing loads more hours at work, so I only managed to read about 3 books, but I've only got like 100 pages left of this, so I kind of lied, and I did it so that in my January wrap-up, so that this would be like one of my books that counts towards January. So I know it's cheating, but I think we've all done it at some point, right? So this needs to get finished today, I decided. Lunchtime, it's about 3:30. I usually do eat pretty late. I've got a very burnt pita bread and just some hummus, and then I've also got a salad. So I've just got some mixed leaves, some beetroot, some feta cubes, halloumi, and avocado. So yeah, I'm really excited about this because with my schedule I never usually kind of eat healthy, because it's just easier for me and quicker for me to like have some fast food. So yeah, I'm really excited just to eat this and then watch The Dig on Netflix. Hey, so I've just finished The Dig and it was incredible. I would literally recommend it to all of you guys. I almost cried at the end, it was so emotional. So yeah, I need to get some seminar work done now for tomorrow, because I've got a seminar at 10. I've done my seminar work for my seminar from 9 till 10, but yeah, from 10 till 11 I need to read some accounts on Boudicca, which is, it's so interesting, but I must admit I'm not really feeling too well at the moment. I think my period's due soon, so I think that's probably why I'm just feeling a little bit ill. But yeah, time to do some seminar work. Please don't disappear. Yeah, I know that I have got this all wrong. I'm reaching out to touch your voice. I'm looking kind of crazy and worse for wear, but I have just finished studying for the night. Oh, I need to sort myself out because this is not a good look. But yeah, I've just finished my seminar prep for the night. I just need to like write up all my things for the questions. To be fair, it's probably going to be a little bit last minute because it's at 10 o'clock tomorrow, but it's all right. I'm just going to go downstairs now and have a very late dinner. I must admit, I do eat my dinner. Well, I say tea or dinner. I do eat it really late. Because what time is it now? Oh, it's 9:15. Yeah. So one thing you'll know about me is, well, one thing that you will notice about me is that my eating schedule is just very off. Like, I eat at the weirdest times. So, yeah. But I'm going to go downstairs now with my friends. We're going to start War and Peace. And then I'm going to finish this as well, because I've got like 70 pages left, I think. So yeah, to be fair, not a lot has really happened in this book. I'm not sure how I'm going to rate it, change my Goodreads rating. I think I gave it 4 stars, but I'm going to change it to 3, I think. I just bought a Cancun of Depop for £5. And like, bear in mind, it was really, really dirty. So I messaged all my friends and I showed all my friends. And I was like, guys, like, it is extremely dirty, but I think it might be worth it. And obviously, if I just like... It will take a lot of cleaning and dedication, but for £5, it's worth it. And it's authentic as well. I asked her, is it authentic? She's like, yes. So it is a good day for Chloe Roberts. Hey guys, so it is Thursday morning and it's about half nine. I've just finished one of my drop-in sessions, and there was literally six of us out of like 22 that were supposed to be there. Oh, no, bless him. I really like my lecturer, though, that I have for that. He's, like, my favourite lecturer. But it's just a bit weird, though, as well, because he made us all, like, introduce ourselves and go round. And, it, I mean, as you can tell with my voice right now, my voice always goes so weird when I wake up. It just sounds very strange and, like, I don't know, coffee. It's weird. So I'm going to really quickly go and get some breakfast because then I've got a seminar at 10 till 11. Cocoa Pops. Coffee and rewatching Moira Winnie, and I only have 5 minutes before my seminar, so let's go. So I've just finished my workout and I've showered, and this looks so unappetizing, but honestly I just really fancied it, as I'm really hungry for a snack. So I've just got some toast, butter and Marmite, and I'm gonna read some more of Sentinel, because oh my god, stuff is happening, and I'm only like 70 pages in, but stuff is already happening, and which is really exciting compared to like the last book where there wasn't as much action. So yeah, I'm just gonna do that, then do my lecture notes, which I've already got ready. And yeah, but it's just started raining even more, which is nasty.
What you say tells me nothing. What's the truth? Give me something. Down the road I believe in.
Hey guys, so it's Friday, well, mid-morning, nearly noon, it's like 11 o'clock. I kind of woke up about an hour ago, just kind of washed my hair and got ready for the day, because today I'm leaving for the library, even though the weather, it isn't much nicer. I thought and prayed that it would be, but it's not. So yeah, this is going to be a very gloomy vlog, I'm afraid, so I do apologise about that. So I'm just going to get some breakfast, and then I've got a seminar for my favourite module, AG and Prehistory, from 12 to 1, so I'll take you guys along that with me as well. And then yeah, it's library time.
This, in fact, is the period of the introduction of the pottery wheel. This town
So that's my library over there, which I just texted my books from. Just walk through the tunnel, just come around here. Yeah, and this is kind of like the beginning of Newcastle City Centre now. And here is my favourite museum, and this is the Great North Museum. So I'm actually really lucky because this museum is partnered with the uni, so it means that I kind of get experiences to actually handle some of the artefacts and stuff. For example, last year I had the opportunity to handle some of the Greek coins and like some of the Roman artefacts that are in the Hancock collection. So honestly, it was such a great experience, and I hope I get to do it again soon. But yeah, this is the gorgeous museum. And welcome to the main campus of Newcastle. Okay, so I'm actually lucky enough to have lectures in this amazing building. So this is the Armstrong building, and it's the kind of like the history, the classics, and the English one. Yeah. I'm honestly just so lucky to have such a gorgeous campus. So I'll show you guys around a bit more. Basic tour of my beautiful campus, and I think this is like a really perfect place to actually end my vlog for the week. The weather is taking a turn for the worst, it's getting more rainy, so I'm just gonna quickly walk home, and yeah, I hope you guys have enjoyed the vlog, and I'll see you guys in a bit.
This town will never change.